Greetings, fellow YouTubers. My name is Drock, world builder, lead sound designer, and coder for Altarion. ShadowFX has found himself indisposed, so he asked me to record an update for the month of September. As many of you know, there were some challenges with the summer solstice event that caused it to be postponed, and then divided into two parts. The second part of the storyline began on September 8th and will wrap up on September the 22nd. The event features characters, places, and objects from the Dungeons & Dragons campaign ShadowFX ran as Dungeon Master for his wife Kagome, myself, and my wife Capitolina, with some lesser involvement from other family members. I personally have been using the material we devised from our gameplay to enrich the lore of Altarion as a whole. Along with adding various details across the game, I have been updating equipment, mobs, and rooms in mid-level areas, starting in and around Roundoff. Of particular note is the ongoing update to the Candlewood Forest that will intersect with Morpheus's update of Cal Toresh, the Dwarf Village. Speaking of Morpheus, in between building projects, he has been laying some groundwork for the Halloween event, which will be augmented by some special code I made just for the occasion. Expect to see a new bonus class come online for his event. Speaking of code, we've seen a variety of quality of life contributions from Valorant, aka Lokar, as well as the new spell Lightning Arrow, an obscure level 15 spell that adds the electrical ED type to carried ammunition. He also made some changes to how Sense Life, Detect Undead, and Dread Portent interact with different types of hidden mobs. Had Solace and Poison Ivy in the Vampiric Vines to prevent their continued aggression, and a host of minor string changes and additions, including hint strings for low-level warrior skills. Brock has been working on saving throw standardization for mobs, which is largely unseen and unappreciated by players. It should lead to less cosmopolitan suites of saving throws for mobs. Brock also added some potion tracking / denting code and guild rank dependency for skills, starting with reinforced armor. As for me, I've been a busy little beaver. I've made some sweeping changes to crafting, including raising the experience they gain, especially for creating mastercraft pieces. Leather crafting, tailoring, wood crafting, and bone crafting now make equipment with total levels instead of primary level, putting them on parity with lapidary and metallurgy. You can now designate a level range or target to tailor for, but you must specify a color and fabric type. And several new crafted items are now available, such as leather-crafted knee pads and forged mining helmets. The mining helmets don't actually do anything for mining, Shrith just wanted them. There have been significant changes to the lapidary code. Players will notice almost no difference. However, this forking of functions has allowed me to create a special building code that can create random lapidary gems that load as treasures inside of containers. Also, quartzes such as citrine, amethyst, and smoky quartz can sometimes be rutilated. This means they have inclusions of needles of rutile for the uninitiated. Gods now have a favored brewing affinity for brewing unguents. This should make it much easier for the followers of certain gods to make unguents at full strength. These poor Denton worshippers trying to find Ardale spell comps. There is a new settable option, Autocraft ID. When Autocraft ID is active, you will automatically identify objects as you finish crafting them. I added two new channel cast runes, Erum and Shul. I'll add more shortly. Flexible weapons trigger double attack more often and let you hit an additional target with cleave. I made grenades do more damage, but mobs that are alert, i.e. have been recently attacked, have a high chance to avoid most or all the damage. I plan on using alertness code for more things in the future, since it's there. I added a new cleric spell at level 16, Sunbeam. This beam attack does extra damage to undead, shadow, and ethereal creatures. The spell that it is dependent on, Radiant Orbs, now does extra damage to shadows as well. The thief skill, Salvage Equipment, has been bumped down to level 27. And a new thief skill, dependent upon salvage equipment and metallurgy, has been added at level 28, Scrap Equipment. This skill allows thieves to break down metallic objects into bits of scrap. These small scraps can be smelted and refined at forges to produce workable metal. I opened a new level 7 area on the Isle of Slowey, La Costa Ventosa, the Windy Coast. It embraces some themes seen in Shadowfax's event areas. If anyone's interested, I made an amphibian mob type, because murlocs are not reptiles. Thank you for listening. Thank you for your interest. I hope you find these updates edifying. If you have been playing with us, please continue to enjoy our little world and its content. If you've not played Alterion, feel free to navigate to www.alterion.com and click on the Getting Started link. For sighted players, I highly recommend our custom client, the D-Client. We should be getting our music working for Windows players once Denton gets the audio stack sorted out. You know, Microsoft can be. Like and share on social media, and feel free to subscribe for more monthly updates and other content. We hope to see you soon on Alterion.
That concludes this monthly update. Archives and resources for our audio updates can be found at www.lawful-evil.org/videos. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel for more presentations like this one, or follow us on Facebook or Twitter. We invite you and your friends to come play this month with us on Alterion, where every day is an adventure. Thanks for listening, and happy mudding, everybody!
Alterion.com. That's Alterion.com.